Day 4 Phantom Crash Test. The potential of an airplane terrorist attack on a nuclear facility has troubled the governments for decades. This explains why the US government tested and filmed an F-4 Phantom jet, fully loaded at 42,000 pounds, being launched and slammed directly into a concrete wall at nearly 500 miles per hour. The Sandia National Laboratories undertook the test and its rocket sled facility in Albuquerque, New Mexico on April 19, 1988. A fully functioning F-4 was used in the impact test. Only the gears, flaps, the main wings were partly removed and replaced by a carriage structure and sleds. Sandia Labs used water in the plane's fuel tank to simulate the mass of the jet fuel because, according to the lab, quote, "the effects of the fire followed them such a collision was not a part of the test and crashed head-on into a reinforced 12-foot thick concrete wall at almost 500 miles per hour. It perfectly imitated those high-speed crash of a plane into a nuclear facility concrete walls. The plane was obliterated until literally into millions of tiny pieces. The only sections which remained intact with a small section of wing which missed the target entirely. Conversely, damage to the wall was very small. The wall's maximum scar depth was 2.36 inches. While structural damage sustained was negligible, the force of the impact did hurl the concrete block 5.97 feet. It just proved the reinforced concrete could stop a plane inflicting a major damage like hitting a nuclear facility. As with other such crash tests, some questioned the findings and even contested the physical level. In the photos, the skeptics noted that the jet didn't appear to slow down in the footage. They also note how its fuselage didn't crumble, its cockpit window didn't crack or shatter, and its wing and tail fins didn't jolt forward after it started crashing onto the fortified barrier. The Boeing 727 crash. An unmanned Boeing 727 crash test dummies and scientific instrument crash landed on purpose into the ground. The intentional crash occurred on April 27, 2012, Mexico in Baja California. The test crash was done for a TV documentary for the UK channel for Discovery Channel in Germany's ProSieben channel, the aim of which was to create a serious but survivable airline crash with a real aircraft on board with numerous force gauges to measure the shock upon landing. There were also 15 crash test dummies coated in grease paint to signal their trajectory at the moment of the impact of the interior and exterior of the plane. And it had multiple cameras as well. Footage shows the plane flying in low and shallow. The jetliner hit the ground at 140 miles per hour. The descent rate was 1500 feet per minute. In addition to the cockpit fully detaching from the cabin, the only pieces that came undone with the trim around the main cabin in the emergency oxygen mask that deployed. Surprisingly, many of the overhead bins stayed secured. An interesting finding was, the passengers at the front of the plane were indeed more likely to get hurt than those at the back. Many of the passengers would have sustained serious injuries and many in first class would likely have perished in the impact. Also, for the first time in such a test, it was shown that the bracing for impact was indeed a good idea. It was clear that those who had been positioned to brace for impact minimized the damage to their lumbar spine and were also protected from flying debris. However, there were doubts about the scientific validity of the experiment, given that it used almost a 50-year-old aircraft design. The test was also forbidden from being done in the US. The Boeing 727 used in the test was owned by a Singapore Airlines and was chosen because it was cheap. Channel 4 confirmed that the pilot parachuted out before impact. 1950s Airplane Fire Test. The post-World War II era was the golden age of commercial aviation. However, a significant concern was that a fire during and after an airplane crash. The crash fire issue was of direct interest to the aircraft industry, to the aircraft manufacturers, and to the increasing successful commercial airline operators like the Pan Am, American United, American Airlines, United, Transworld, etc. In 1947, the Committee on Operating Problems tasked the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, known as the NACA, with how to control or prevent airplane fires. Coincidentally, NACA also later became NASA. In 1949, NACA had obtained 50 twin-engine cargo plane from the US Air Force that had been used during the famous Berlin airlift. Those were tired and beaten hardy aircraft, and so they were perfect for crash test. In fact, the airlines were so worn down that when they were flown to the Cleveland, their doors were opened, so in case of emergency, the pilot could get out if necessary. Ravenna, Ohio was chosen as the site for the full-scale crash test. It had been used by the Army as an armament depot during the World War. The construction of a 200-foot runway at the Ravenna site was just needed for the test. Each test crash was carefully choreographed and was staged to be survivable, since the emphasis was on the fires that could break out. In the test, a plane would take off and be landed by remote controls and ran into a barrier that tore off the landing gear and damaged the propellers. The plane with hurdles through a row of poles, ripping open the wing, tanks and setting off fires. The plane was painted white and the fuel dyed red for ease of photography. The goal of the test was to uncover the mechanism of fire during and after a crash, as well as the exact nature of the structural breakup of the airplane. Some old myths were also busted due to the test. For example, the mistaken belief of some pilots that turning off the ignition before a crash prevented the fire. Well, it didn't. Also, that was the belief that fuels with low volatility were safer than the conventional gasoline. They were not. By 1957, countless tests resulted in fire-related engineering analysis, perfect for turbo-powered jets. However, airlines were under no obligations to make the scientifically proven safety changes. NACA failed to entice them or the manufacturers to incur the added expense of the system.